Fingolimod capsules is used to treat multiple sclerosis. It is not a cure for multiple sclerosis, but it is thought to help by preventing immune system cells, lymphocytes, from attacking the nerves in your brain and spinal cord. It helps decrease the number of episodes of worsening and may prevent or delay disability. Indications. Fingolimod is used to prevent episodes of symptoms and slow the worsening of disability in adults and children 10 years of age and older with relapsing remitting forms. Course of disease where symptoms flare up from time to time of multiple sclerosis. A disease in which the nerves do not function properly and people may experience weakness, numbness, loss of muscle coordination, and problems with vision, speech, and blood control. How to use? The capsules should be swallowed intact without opening them. Fingolimod capsules can be taken with or without food. In adults and pediatric patients 10 years of age and older weighing more than 40 kg, the recommended dosage of fingolimod is 0.5 mg orally once daily. In pediatric patients 10 years of age and older weighing less than or equal to 40 kg, the recommended dosage of fingolimod is 0.25 mg orally once daily. Fingolimod doses higher than 0.5 mg are associated with a greater incidence of adverse reactions without additional benefit. Pediatric patients who start on 0.25 mg capsule and subsequently reach a stable body weight above 40 kg should be switched to 0.5 mg capsules. When switching from a 0.25 mg to a 0.5 mg daily dose, it is recommended to repeat the same first dose monitoring as for treatment initiation. The same first dose monitoring as for treatment initiation is recommended when treatment is interrupted for one day or more during the first 2 weeks of treatment, more than 7 days during week 3 and 4 of treatment, more than 2 weeks after 1 month of treatment. Contraindications. Immunodeficiency syndrome. Patients with increased risk for opportunistic infections, including immunocompromised patients, including those currently receiving immunosuppressive therapies, or those immunocompromised by prior therapies. Severe active infections, active chronic infections, hepatitis, tuberculosis, active malignancies, severe liver impairment. Patients who in the previous 6 months had myocardial infarction, unstable angina pectoris, stroke, transient ischemic attack, decompensated heart failure, requiring inpatient treatment. Patients with severe cardiac arrhythmias requiring antiarrhythmic treatment. Patients with second-degree Moebius type 2 atrioventricular block or third-degree AV block or six-sinus syndrome if they didn't wear a pacemaker. During pregnancy and in women of childbearing potential not using effective contraception. Hypersensitivity to the active substance or tone of the excipients. Special warnings and precautions for use. After the first dose, the decline in heart rate starts within 1 hour and is maximal within 6 hours. This post-dose effect persists over the following days, although usually to a mild extent and usually abates over the next weeks. With continued administration, the average heart rate returns toward baseline within 1 month. However, individual patients may not return to baseline heart rate by the end of the first month. Conduction abnormalities were typically transient and asymptomatic. They usually didn't require treatment and resolve within the first 24 hours of treatment. If necessary, the decrease in heart rate induced by fingolimod can be resolved by parenteral doses of atropine or isoprenoline. The same precautions are for the first dose are recommended when patients are switched from the 0.25 mg to the 0.5 mg daily dose. Antineoplastic, immunomodulatory or immunosuppressive therapies should not be co-administered due to the risk of additive immune system effects. Side effects. Fingolimod may cause side effects. Tell a doctor if any of the symptoms are severe or do not go away. Weakness, back pain, pain in the hands or feet, diarrhea, abdominal pain, nausea, headache or migraine, hair loss. Some side effects can be serious. If you experience any of the symptoms, call doctor immediately. Slow heartbeat, rash, hives, itching, swelling of the face, eye, mouth, throat, tongue or lips, or difficulty swallowing or breathing. Sore throat, body aches, fever, chills, cough, and other signs of infection and during treatment and for 2 months after your treatment. Headache, neck stiffness, fever, sensibility to light, nausea or confusion during treatment and 2 months after your treatment. Painful, burning, numb or tingling feeling on skin, sensitivity to touch, rash or itching during treatment and 2 months after your treatment. Sudden severe headache, confusion, changes in vision or seizures. Blurriness, shadows or a blind spot in the center of your vision. Sensitivity to light, unusual color to your vision or other vision problems. Changes to an existing mole, a new darkened area on skin. Sores that do not heal. Growths on your skin such as a bump that may be shiny, pearly white, skin colored or pink. Or any changes to your skin. Weakness on one side of the body or clumsiness on the arms or legs that worsens over time, changes in your thinking, memory, or balance. Confusion or personality changes, or loss of strength. Neuro worsening shortness of breath. Nausea, vomiting, loss of appetite, abdominal pain. Yellowing of skin or eyes, or dark urine. Fingolimod may increase the risk of developing skin cancer and lymphoma, cancer that binds in the cells that fight infection. Talk to a doctor about the risk of taking this medication.